This is Mr. Raghvendra Rao. I am here to talk about on natural selection. I have included a picture of Darwin. Most people think that he is famous because he somehow invented evolution. But that is not totally accurate. So while Charles Darwin is famous, for he is the first scientist that really explain the mechanism of evolution, especially in case of adaptations. So here, when we talk about, so we have to touch various concepts like, first of all, we will look into the evolution. So evolution is change in the heritable characters of the biological population over successive generation. So that is passed on from parents to offspring during the reproduction. That is what we generally consider it as evolution. So evolution is directly connected with the gene pool. So we all know that the total genes present in a population is in general considered it as a gene pool. So the total number of genes which are present in a population, we generally call it as a gene pool. Means here, varieties of allelic frequencies are in general maintained in a population, which is in general considered as gene pool. So when we talk about gene pool, evolution and gene pool always maintain uniform when there is a phenomenon of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. If these five constraints are not occurring in the nature, then there won't be any evolution, there won't be any change in the gene pool. But if these are going to occur, basically you will see the mechanism of evolution. So large size, no large size, random mating, no random mating, no mutation, no migration, if all these things means is there won't be any evolution and the equilibrium is always maintained. So we are not talking about all these things, but we are going to talk regarding the selection today. So that is natural selection. So natural selection is a phenomenon. It is a live and die according to the condition of your parents. When the organism is able to live in the available circumstances of environmental factors, so the parent is able to successfully pass on the genes to the next generation. So that's why when there is a change in the environment, according to the change in the environment, if organisms adapt to that, acclimatize to that, then it is operating natural selection. So it is a kind of differential reproductive success where the successful organism pass on their genes to the next generation so that they can survive in the changed environment. So when the person or the organism is surviving in the changed environment, we can say that it is having best fitness. So it has a high fitness towards the environment. So that's why it is able to establish itself and it communicates its generation after generation by the process of inheritance of those genes. If this fitness is for a long period of time, then it turns to be an adaptation. Means if you are able to see the natural selection is operating in an organism generation after generation, it is in general becomes an adaptation. So adaptation is in general process of selection, what we can say. It is a process for the selection. So in this juncture, we are going to look into one of the example which is very famous talking about adaptation. So here you have been infected with various kinds of bacteria. You have a nearly 7 strains of bacteria and you have been infected with these bacteria and you are going to be treated with the antibiotics. So when you are treating with antibiotics, basically imagine you have used an antibiotic called penicillin. Now the penicillin has got a wide range of spectrum. It can kill wide varieties of bacteria. Now after the application of antibiotic, generally you have seen there are some bacteria which are, in general, they are eliminated. So these five different strains of bacteria, they are eliminated. When these five are eliminated, the leftover ones are in general considered to be the most resistant one. So this one and this one, or these two bacteria are, they are said to be resistant to this antibiotic. The rest of the five bacteria, which are in general, could not resist themselves against the antibiotic, so they are susceptible. So they are susceptible to antibiotic, that's why they are killed. And by the process of selection, the resistant varieties of bacteria have got selected. Now what happens? These selected bacteria will start reproducing by binary fission. And they have started growing their final population. Means what we can say that among the seven bacteria, only these two strains of bacteria are selected by the nature due to the presence of a kind of resistant towards the antibiotic. When we talk about the resistance, so this is the high level of resistance to, gradually the resistant level will decrease to the yellow. Yellow is the low level of resistance in the bacteria. So this is accordingly, normally the natural selections is operating here. Basically, what we can say, how these populations get variations. Now, here is a question, out of seven, why these two only have got selected, why the rest of the five have eliminated? So in the nature, we know that organisms will get variation by two methods. So one, we consider it as the novel variations are brought into the organisms by the phenomenon called as mutation. So this is one way where normally the variety can be brought into the organism. Mutation is nothing but it is an inheritable sudden change in the nucleic acid sequences in the DNA, which brings the variation, or basically we consider it as a mutation. The second one, which is considered as a reproduction. Here, what we can say that even though the bacteria reproduce asexually by binary fission, they have a mechanism to introduce variations. They are also having a special mechanism to introduce variation, which induces the variety in the bacterial colony. So this is how normally the adaptation can be seen in the organisms by two methods. One is of mutation, another one is, that is what we generally call it, a reproduction. Basically, in sexually reproducing organisms also, when they go for the sexual reproduction, definitely it induces the variation. The major cause of variation in higher animals and plants is mainly because of the sexual reproduction. Because sexual reproduction introduces variation due to the presence of a mechanism called as meiosis. Now we will take a famous example which is talking about this kind of what we can say that a natural selection example, which is very, very important and famous example, which is called as industrial mineralization. Basically, you are able to see two different varieties of moths here. This is a light colored pepper moth and this is a dark colored pepper moth. The scientific name of this moth is called Biston betularis. Basically, before 1800, in the sense, before the industrial revolution in UK, we have seen the tree trunks are densely covered with lichens. You are able to see these are the different kinds of fruit cakes, crustos, and different types of lichens which are covering over the trunks. We all know that the lichens are the indicators of zero air pollution. So due to the absence of air pollution, so the lichens used to grow massively with a thick cushion over the trunks of the trees, and on those the light colored pepper moth used to blend. This is the moth which we see. This is the light colored pepper moth which is blended over the lichen. So this could not be seen by the predators. So this moth could not be seen by the predators because it has a blended its color with the background. So the, a kind of a camouflage is in general seen in this condition, where this moth has been selected naturally during those prevailing conditions, made this light colored pepper moth, where it has been selected, and this selection made a differential reproductive success. And you have seen mostly the number of light colored moths is increased drastically. Similarly, when we talk about the dark colored moth, so very here the predators can very clearly observe the dark colored moth on a light background. So most of the predators used to predate on dark color pepper moth. So due to which the population of dark color moth is decreased. Somehow, basically, it is not completely eliminated from the nature, but somehow it can manage when this particular dark color moth will fall on a location where it gets blended with the background color. So in that way, some of the dark colored moths, they got survived, and their population is also seen along with the light colored population. But the number of individuals of the light pepper moth are very, very high when it is compared to the number of dark colored moths. When we talk about the genes which are regulating the color of this, basically we can say that the light colored moth is in general considered to be the recessive. So it is denoted with small d, and the dark color moth is in general considered to be the dominant. So it dominant in the sense it can be denoted with capital D or capital D small d, either homozygous dominant or heterozygous dominant. But the light colored moth is controlled by alleles which are small d, homozygous condition. So these two small recessive alleles, homozygous recessive alleles, are controlling this kind. So this is the condition before 1800, when there is no industrial revolution in the UK, which has led to the situation, and which was natural. Nature is selecting the light colored moth in this situation. So next, after that, when we look into the after industrialization, the industrialization has started nearly in 1800 year. So after 1800, there are several coal companies have established. So establishment of coal companies has started emitting the coal dust. So in the environment, due to the coal dust used to accumulate on the trunks, where the trunks have devoid of lichens, because I have said the lichens are the indicators of air pollution. When there is an air pollution, generally they are eliminated from the nature. You don't see the growth of lichens in air polluted zone. So due to that, normally the soot and the dust which is deposited over the trunk, basically it has turned dark in color. On this dark background, the predators could not see the dark pepper moth, but they are readily able to see the light colored moth. Now in this situation, after the industrialization, the dark colored pepper moth has got advantage for the natural selection process, where the previously natural selected light colored pepper moth has a disadvantage due to the industrialization process. Now, which has made there is an immense decrease in the population of the light colored moth due to the continuous predation of light colored pepper moth over the dark color pepper moth. So this is the famous example, which is in general considered to be the one of the example for which is called as a natural selection, and we consider this as industrial melanization. Now, when we talk about a Hardy-Weinberg equation regarding this particular alleles in the population, when we talk about this, around in the 1848 year, when we look into the allelic frequency of light colored as well as dark colored moths, 98% of the allelic frequency are from, in general, basically you will see the light colored moth, only 2% will be from the dark colored. So when we calculate, that is 98% of the populations are in general of light colored, and 2% of the population are of dark color. So when you exactly finding out the allelic frequency of these things, as I mentioned, this is of basically the allelic frequencies can be calculated by substituting the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium equation, that is p square plus 2pq plus q square is equal to 1. Now here we all know that the p square denotes capital T, that is homozygous dominant, and 2pq stands for 2 heterozygous dominant, plus q square always denominates that it is of small d is equal to 1. Now we all know that the light colored pepper moth number is 98%, which is denoting small d, and this 2% is in general denoting either of capital D or capital D small d. Now you can substitute these values in this equation, that q square is equal to, when we convert that 98% into decimal, it becomes 0.98. Now if you make a square root of this, both 0.98 in the sense, it roughly comes 0.99 is the allelic frequency of light colored pepper moth. So this very clearly denotes that the 99% of the allelic frequencies in the populations are of light colored moth. Only 1% of the allelic frequency is of, that is 0.1, it is not even 1, it is a 0.1% of allelic frequency is of dark color. So in this way, this is a simple Hardy-Weinberg problem solution to know the allelic frequency in this way, either it is a dominant, or either it is a heterozygous, or it is a homozygous recessive. Whichever the allelic frequency you want to know, you can calculate with the help of this equation, which is proposed by Hardy-Weinberg. So which has really given an impression that you can see that, so out of all these, what we can say that, so here it is showing all these are 99 are of allelic alleles of light colored pepper moth, means it is nearly 99, and this is only 1. So this is of allelic frequency of dark colored pepper moth. So in this juncture, what we can say that at the time of 1848, so the light colored pepper moth, your allelic frequency in the population is almost all 99%, and dark colored pepper moth allelic frequency is contributing 1%. In this way, normally we have seen a situation where the situation has favored the population of light colored pepper moth over the dark colored pepper moth. It is due to the natural selection phenomenon, which has given a differential reproductive ability, and it has increased its population by inheriting the resistance genes or whatever the genes from one generation to another generation. When we talk about the next situation, what happened after 50 years? What is the situation? What is the situation? So in this juncture, as I mentioned, there is a heavy industrialization which has readily changed the situation and which also affected the drastically the gene pool of the pepper moth population. Now we have seen the data which has shown very astonishing, and it is quite reverse, where 1848 we have seen the light colored pepper moth population is of 98% and dark color is of 2%. After 50 years, when we collect the data, they have actually collected the data in 1895, they have seen quite astonishing results. Earlier, the light colored pepper moth, which used to be 98%, has become now only 5%. And now the 2% earlier, which is of dark colored pepper moth, has now it has been raised to 95% of the population. So in this scenario, we can say that the factors which are present in the environment after the industrialization has selectively affecting the favorable towards the dark colored pepper moth over the light colored one. When we also calculate the allelic frequency of 1895 situation, basically here also you can say that p square plus 2pq plus q square is equal to 1. This stands capital D, capital D. This stands 2, capital D, small d. And this stands small d, small d. Now you substitute the small d value. Here earlier it is 0.98. Now it is not 0.98. The q square is equal to 0.05. Now if you square root this q value, it comes nearly around 0.22. It comes nearly around 0.2. So now earlier we have seen a situation where all these are of light colored pepper moth allelic frequency, which is nearly of 99%, and only one is the dark colored pepper moth frequency. Now after 50 years, it has quite astonishingly, the gene pool has changed, which has resulted, see, nearly 22% only we see the existence of light colored pepper moth allelic frequency. Rest of the 78% of the allelic frequency changed over the 50 years to dark pepper moth population. So this is in general, after the industrialization, it has favored the dark color moth over light. So this made this dark colored pepper moth genes to be inherited from one generation to another generation, which has led successfully a mechanism of differential reproductive success. Which has led to an adaptation. So this is how normally the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium gives you over the time period how the gene pool has shifted from majority of light colored pepper moth gene allelic frequency to dark colored pepper moth. Even though the light color is not eliminated, it is having 22% of the allelic frequency when it is compared to the 78% of the dark color allelic frequency. Now, when we talk about the real process, adaptation is a process that for natural selection. Means in the sense, selection when it is operated, it leads to the adaptation process. Adaptation is a process that selected for a best suited organism in the prevailing existing environmental conditions. So here there is a good example. You are able to see different types of fishes, which we generally, this is, you can very clearly notice such kind of adaptation in the Rift Valley, which is in South Africa, means southern parts of the Africa, where it has got different types of varieties of lakes which are distributed over the area. Basically, when we look into these lakes, you are able to see a special kind of fishes which are inhabited. We call them as secret fishes. So these fishes are basically are having two types of jaws. This is a normal jaw which we see in all fishes, but along with that, it has got another jaw which is called as a pharyngeal jaw. So this is a pharyngeal jaw that you can keep very clearly notice. This is another, this is a jaw which is normally seen, this is a jaw which is normally seen, but along with that, you are also able to see another jaw which is called as a pharyngeal jaw. So the pharyngeal jaw is also very well developed in these fishes, which has led to explore different food. So they used to explore different kinds of foods in these lakes, and which has made them to visit different niches. In that those lakes, and due to that, what happens? You will see the population of these cichlid fishes exploded in these lakes because they have well adapted to this soup, well adapted to these lakes. So this is how normally natural selection in the long run, basically it operates in a population, and it makes the population effective, and it distributes by specially only a process by called as differential reproductive success. So the other way to the natural selection, it is nothing but natural selection is simply differential reproductive success.